Next heading I'm going to discuss expressing a cos x plus b sin x in the single trigonometric function, either sine or cos. You need to combine this in terms of sine or cos only. So how do we do that? A cos x plus b sin x equal to c. Set. Okay. So what we have to do? Just we have to divide by coefficient sum of squares of coefficients of sin x and cos x. In what? Just divide both side by sum of squares of coefficients of sine and cos. So here we have to divide a square plus b square equal to c upon under root a square plus b square. Okay. Now we need to decide, either we need to send it in sine form or cos form. For sine, this value should be, for sin a plus b, sin a cos b, so this should be sin of some angle plus this should be cos of some angle, right? So let sin theta equal to a upon under root a square plus b square. So we can check out if this is theta, sin means perpendicular, this is hypotenuse. So this will be b. So this value b upon under root a square plus b square automatically will be b upon under root a square plus b square. So this is going to be sin theta cos x plus cos theta sin x equal to c upon under root a square plus b square. So this is formula for sin theta plus x, fine, equal to c upon under root a square plus b square, right? So we have converted this in terms of sine. Similarly, we can convert the whole thing in the cos. How? We can assume in place of sine theta, this value will be cos theta and this will be sine theta. Right, so formula will be cos theta cos x plus sin theta sin x will be cos theta minus x. So it will be cos theta minus x equal to c upon under root a square plus b square. Fine. So in terms of sin and cos, we can convert it. So we know that maximum value of sin or cos is 1 and minimum value for sin or cos is minus 1. Excuse me. So what in terms of cos, we will get cos theta minus x will be c upon a square plus b square. If we assume cos theta equal to a upon under root a square plus b square, then we will get this. Fine. So we know that maximum and minimum value of sine is 1 and minimum will be minus 1. Hence c upon under root a square plus b square will go to the maximum one, minimum minus 1. So c will go to the maximum under root a square plus b square, and minimum will be minus of under root a square plus b square. Right? So this, suppose this is the fx. So maximum value of fx will be under root a square plus b square, and minimum will be minus under root a square plus b square. Let me solve some examples on the base of this. Suppose someone is asking, find the range of fx, where fx equal to 1 upon cos x minus 3 whole square plus sin x plus 4 whole square. Fine. So let us solve. What is the denominator? So cos x minus 3 whole square plus sin x plus 4 whole square can be written as cos square x plus 9 minus 6 cos x plus sin square x plus 16 plus 8 sin x. So sin square plus cos square is 1, and 16 9, what is that? 16 plus 9, 16, 25, and 1, 26 minus 6 cos x plus 8 sin x. But we know that minus 6 cos x plus 8 sin x maximum will be under root of sum of squares of sin and cos. Similarly, minimum will be this. Right, so but 26 is there, so add 26 all the sides. So what we are getting? 26 minus 6 cos x plus 8 sin x will be, I think, 64 plus 36, 110. So it is 36 there. Minus 10 plus 6, 26, 16. And the value of fx, 1 upon, right? So on the maximum value, 1 will reverse. So it will go to the minimum, because 1 upon 36 will be the minimum, and maximum will be 1 upon 16. So this is the range of fx. Fine.